I live in a place in Northern California where I have zero gravel roads to train on. So I spend a lot of time on my gravel bike, but with road tires on it. So I train on the bike that I'm gonna race because I want my body to become really accustomed to the fit, the position on that bike. And then I just try to find those little patches of gravel where I can to practice my handling, because the handling obviously is a little bit different. So you wanna become comfortable with cornering in gravel. That would be the biggest thing I think that people could do, would be to practice turning in gravelly types of situations. But like I said, for me, I live in a place with no gravel, so I spend a lot of time on my gravel bike, but with road tires on the road training. If I had any tips on like bikes or bike builds, find a bike where you can run the biggest tires possible. And that may be a mountain bike, run as you know, with a rigid fork or something like that. But when you're riding gravel, having, you know, 35 or bigger tires is really helpful as far as the contact patch goes, your comfort levels out there, provides a little bit of dampening. So it's kind of, you know, personal choice, but finding a bike that allows you to run as wide of tires as possible would be one of my first tips for folks for bike setup. Obviously, working for a sports nutrition company, I subscribe to the Sip Sip Nibble Nibble nutrition plan, which means you need to constantly be taking in little bits of hydration and food the whole time, because you are going to be operating at a caloric deficit when you're out there for 4, 5, 6 hours, however long it takes. So you need to be constantly bringing in little bits of solids, gels, drinks, water, obviously, to keep your fuel levels as high and topped up as much as possible. Because like a car, you can't run without gas. So you need to keep that food going in the whole time. So a big tip or suggestion for riders is to practice their nutrition plan. Figure out what food works best for you, train with it, so that come race day, your body's used to that and knows how to work with that kind of fuel. The RPI course is gorgeous. It's mind-blowing. It's stunning. I mean, you start with, I forget the name of it, the really long climb out of the canyon, out of Sun Valley, which sort of separates the field, and then you're treated to an amazing descent down into the back valley, and it can be a little bit stuttery, but it's just a vast, open, beautiful landscape. And I try to, you know, take in as much as possible when I'm out there riding, because it's so different from where I come from. I just try to absorb as much of the beauty as possible when I'm out there riding my bike. I mean, RPI is up there with some of the best gravel races out there. I mean, you've got the beauty of Sun Valley to begin with, so you're doing it in an amazing outdoor location. The course is stunning. You have two options. You have the small fry and the big potato. So what is that, 50 and I think 100 miles or something like that. And then the after party is great. The different brands, the food, the camaraderie, the Galande Coffee Championships. So it's sort of the whole package. It combines everything of drawing people into an amazing vacation type setting, but then you have the physical challenge of going out and pushing your limits. You have the beauty all around you, and then you conclude with all of your friends that you've just spent the day riding bikes with an awesome party that goes into the wee hours of the night. I guess my only other tip, and you know, this comes from the queen herself, having spent years hanging out with her and riding with her, and maybe now that I'm getting a little more up there in age, is to make your ride more about place than placing. You know, remember that you're out there to enjoy it, and don't get so caught up in your physical performance, but rather just soak in all the beauty around you and the camaraderie of the folks that are there doing it with you, and just remember to enjoy the moment.